Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to another Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Well, we're taking a look at Excel 2010 this week, and I want to talk about SmartArt. Now, SmartArt has been around since Excel 2007. It got better in Excel 2010, and I love SmartArt. In fact, my book about SmartArt is the number one best-selling book on SmartArt in the whole world. Okay, it's the only book on SmartArt, but nonetheless, let's take a look at SmartArt. We come here as a great way to communicate a message. We go to Insert, SmartArt. Used to have about 80 different types of SmartArt. They added a couple dozen new ones. All right, so we have the alternating hexagons and a variety of new items that they added to SmartArt. Lots of new things you'll see there. Great new ways to communicate your message. But today I have a message with basically three pieces, so I'm looking for something a little bit vertical here. Let's go with maybe this one. Great. Click OK. And to build the work, you just have to type the items over here in the text box. So I'm going to start off with Joe is in the lead with an amount. And I'm going to get rid of the level 2. Someone else is second with 500. And then the third one, Mary is third with 0. Okay. And so there's our item. The cool things about SmartArt, we can choose the colors. We can choose the effects, all kinds of different 3D effects here to make things look really cool. If you have bad news, you can use this one. No one will be able to read what's going on. So lots of different options here. I'm going to go with that one. And we've had SmartArt for a while. Easy to change the format, so you can see what it would look like in that format or this format. Very versatile what we have here with SmartArt. But the one thing that was missing from Excel 2007 was a way to have the SmartArt dynamically generated from formulas in the spreadsheet. And really, in Excel, that's what we need. So here's what they gave us in Excel 2010. They gave us this icon called Convert to Shapes. It's going to take that SmartArt. So you, first of all, you design the SmartArt, put some dummy text in there, get things as close to looking right as you want, and then convert to shapes. Alright, so now this isn't SmartArt anymore. It's just regular old shapes. It used to be called auto shapes in Excel 2003. And with a shape, what you can do is make sure that the data for the shape comes from a formula in the spreadsheet. So in this case, I want it to be equal to I8. So I click on the shape and say equal I8, press enter, and my text changes. Come here to this shape. And we'll say that that is equal to I9. Great. And then we'll come to the third shape and change that to be equal to I10. All right. Now, as long as you have some cool stuff going on in Excel, I have lots of formulas here. So we keep track of sales here, do some ifs here to add everybody up, use a rank function here to figure out who's first, and then these 1, 2, and 3, these are hard-coded, and use VLOOKUPs to figure out who's number 1, and concatenation to build those messages. Now, as we come along and we have more sales, so here's Bill. Bill has a sale for 1,000. All of the formulas update, and because this SmartArt is now driven from the formulas, it instantly updates. A great improvement over what we had in Excel 2007. Just number 1, because there's more shapes, but secondly, all of that ability to convert those SmartArt to regular auto shapes and have it built from formulas. Beautiful new feature. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. I'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.